Next, we'll go and we'll talk about the hub-type shelter. Now, this is going to work more like a pop-up tent. They're generally square, although you do get some ones that are like a double square extended six-person version. These work really nice when you have two people. You can fit three, but you better be really good friends. And what happens is, so you see these hubs on the sides and also on the top of the shelter. So this will fold up like a pop-up tent, and then you can see the skirt is laid to the inside. You can set that if you desire on the outside, same as the pop-up type. You also see the corners where you can go and set ice anchors into the ice in order to hold this hub shelter down. Now this is pretty light, and it's also very, not very wind resistant. It's something that if it's a windy day, you get this hub shelter pulled up, but not the ice anchor set. You can get it blown around the ice, which can really impact your fishing. Depending on the exact model, I mean, there might be some different features like this here. I use a separate sonar and display. So hanging a tablet in that pocket, three holes, fishing two with the sonar in the middle works really nice for me. You can do the similar thing if you have a regular, you know, Vexlar Markham type ice fishing sonar. They both have their advantages, but you have to look and see what you're doing, how many people you're going, and go and make your judgments based on that when selecting an ice shelter, both for purchase and if you own one, in terms of the kind of service you're looking for if you're working, looking at going on a trip with one or more people.